If you're like me, you've been told on several occasions that your ping was high or your download speed was low because of the bad weather outside. But is that really the case? Do storms really affect the quality of internet connections? And if so, by how much? Well, let's check it out. So, for my testing, I decided to basically benchmark the weather. First up, for full transparency's sake, here's my testing methodology for cable as well as Wi-Fi. I used speedtest.net to measure my ping, download speed and upload speed in sunny, cloudy and stormy weather, using the same server for all tests for maximum consistency. I also did all of my testing around noon and on the same devices. For Wi-Fi testing, I also made sure that the phone I was using was in the same place each time, on the corner of my desk. Another thing worth mentioning is that my internet connection is 500 megabits per second download and 200 megabits per second upload. So now that all that's out of the way, let's see what I have for results. First up, cable, which is known to be more reliable than Wi-Fi. As you can see on this chart right here, sunny weather and cloudy weather speed differences were within the margin of error. But when we throw a storm into the mix, things seem to change. Ping quadruples, going from 4 to 16. It also seems that the delay is highly inconsistent during bad weather, as it varies between 9 and 20 milliseconds, whereas calm weather yielded a steady 4 milliseconds across the board. Average download speeds also went down by about 40 megabits per second, but I'm still getting over 500 megabits, which is what I'm paying for, so you could maybe overlook that, even though sunny and cloudy readings were extremely consistent. On the other hand, upload speeds hovered around a consistent 217 to 218 megabits per second in all weather conditions, which might indicate another cause for the problem, but we'll get to that later in the video. For now, let's take a look at the Wi-Fi results, where the disparities seem much more pronounced. Again, cloudy and sunny weather seem to basically be the same, so I just averaged them together and displayed them as one this time. However, if you go ahead and take a look at stormy weather, the difference is there. Not only is ping 300% higher, but my average download speed went from 44.4 megabits per second all the way down to 24, which is nearly half. Upload speeds did also fall from 33.6 to 28.3 megabits per second, but that, again, seems like a much smaller difference relative to the others. So, we've seen the data, but what should you make of this? There are two options here. First of all, adverse weather conditions can directly impact your connection to the internet. Factors like humidity have been known to impact Wi-Fi signal range, and temperatures may affect poor quality cables, lowering the quality of your connection. But there is another way in which weather affects your internet connection indirectly, which explains why download speeds and ping took a much bigger hit than upload speeds. Think about it. When the weather outside is nice, people go out. But during bad weather conditions, they're stuck inside. And what do? When you have to be indoors? You watch a movie, browse Facebook, watch YouTube videos, go on Twitter, and so on. All of these are very download-intensive activities. For example, streaming a movie or a video from the internet takes a lot of downloading, but little to no uploading. This puts a lot of stress on the network, lowering the overall quality for everybody. Moreover, Wi-Fi network interference skyrockets, further damaging connection quality. And all of that is even more true in summer when I'm running these tests, when kids don't have to go to school and are more likely to be home during bad weather. And that's about it. If you want to see my results for yourself, I will put a link in the description to a Google spreadsheet with all the numbers. Otherwise, I really do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more, you can click on the right to watch my latest video, or on the left to watch a random video, or just click the round channel icon in the middle to subscribe. And as always, this has been Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, bye bye.